Hello, everyone. I'm Cash Finch, and welcome to The Dream of Flight. Before we begin, we would like to acknowledge the land on which we are fortunate to create art and music on. Elders have taught us it's important to acknowledge the land where we gather and the first people who traditionally lived here. It shows respect for the people, their ways of being, belonging, doing, and knowing, which are reflected through stories and songs that have lived on this land for thousands of years. We are making this acknowledgement to demonstrate our commitment to work together as a community in laying the foundation for reconciliation through education. We would like to acknowledge the traditional territories and oral practices of the Blackfoot Nations, which include the Siksika, the Piikani, and the Kainai. We also acknowledge the Tsuut'ina and Stoney Dakota First Nations, the Métis Nation, and all people who make their homes in the Treaty 7 region of Southern Alberta. We have loved creating this show together, and thank you for supporting our work by being in our audience today. Thank you to everyone who has made this production possible for us. A few notes before we begin. There will be a 15-minute intermission between Act 1 and Act 2 with concession items for sale. There are emergency exits located along the sides of the theater, so please take a minute to locate your nearest exit. Please silence your phones and electronic devices and refrain from taking photos and videos during tonight's performance as a sign of respect for our student performers and their privacy. We are very excited to share our work with you today, so without any further ado, please welcome the Central Memorial Concert Choir.
Okawemau Aski, Mother Earth. This is composed by Cheryl Suapegaham, who is an incredible composer from Treaty 6, Cree Dene. And the Cree text translates to Mother Earth, we are your children, we love you.
Way away, high, high, way 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 Welcome to the Dream of Flight. Folks, this has been an incredible experience putting this concert together with these wonderful young musicians. I mean, every day that I get to come to work, I can't help but think what an amazing job I have because I get to work with your kids or your friends, family's kids, or whoever is here. We have over 1,200 people here tonight. This is an incredible, incredible turnout for these wonderful people. Thank you so much for coming. I can't tell you how much it means to all of us. When we were thinking about how we wanted to put this concert together and what we wanted it to be, of course, we always think about what that last piece on the program is going to be. Those of you that have been coming for a few years know how special that is. But we wanted to come up with something that really envisioned the creativity and the optimism and the hope that these students bring to school every day. We wanted to think of something that would inspire us to get through the year as we celebrate our 20th anniversary of being a PVA special department, not just the music department, but we also have this PVA program like the musicians you just saw up here is the PVA band. So as we celebrate that huge milestone, we wanted to do something special this year. And so I've been thinking a lot about what I wanted to say when I got the opportunity to speak to you as a group. And what I keep thinking about is why we do this. And why we work so hard and why, you know, you have to get up so early to get the kids to school and why they have to stay at school so long and what the long days mean. Really, this time that we have at school in music doing these incredible things is because we're trying to figure out just what exactly it is that we're capable of and what we can do. And so we work hard to find out what our limits are and then we see if we can go a little bit past them. The students that you just saw wanted me to tell you how long they had to work on that piece. Not long enough, I think. I say that because most universities would put that together in 6 weeks and we did it faster than that. So the school that you just saw, like just incredible musicians, they did such a great job. Now as we move through the program, you're going to see students from Central Memorial as well as students from three of our most profound feeders. I don't know the best way to say it. We have students here from A.E. Cross. We have students here. Yeah, give them a big cheer. And their director, Jesse Rattan, incredible. We have students from Calgary Girls School and their director, Sarah McLean. And on stage next, you're going to see students from Vincent Massey and their director, Kai Morawski. Now, I'm going to... The program at Central really wouldn't be what it is without you three incredible music teachers bringing your students and working with them every day to get them where they need to go. So this is all possible because of you, and so we're so happy to share the stage with you tonight. I'm going to bring out a couple of students to introduce the Vincent Massey Band. Thank you so much for coming and being part of our celebration tonight.
Hello, my name is Sama, one of the flautists in the PVA Wind Ensemble and Concert Band.
My name is May, and I play the saxophone in both the PVA Wind Ensemble and the Concert Band. We are both very glad to be here, thanks to our experience and time at Vincent Massey Junior High in the band there. We both know that this year they have a new band director, Kai Morawski, and we are both very excited to watch them perform.
We are happy to introduce the Vincent Massey Band, who will be performing Last Voyage of Queen Anne's Revenge by Ryan Meebauer and Shadows Unleashed by Brian Balmages. Please give it up for the Vincent Massey Band!
Thank you.
Oy Horitson, a traditional Ukrainian lullaby that was arranged by Sarah Martinez, and it translates to, oh, the dream passes by the windows and sleep by the fence. The dream asks sleep, where should we rest tonight?
Hi, everybody, and thank you for coming. My name is Nevaeh, and I play the clarinet in the Central PVA Wind Ensemble. We will now welcome the A.E. Cross Senior Band with their band director, Jesse Rattan. They will be performing two songs tonight, Armenian Dances by Alfred Reed, arranged by Douglas E. Wagner, and Procession of the Tsardar, please excuse my pronunciation on this, by Mikhail Ipitolov, arranged by Mark Williams. This is their third concert of the year so far, and they are very excited to be here tonight. As a former AECross student and a musician, I know the passion and dedication that these students put into their work alongside with their hardworking band teacher, Mr. Attan. And give it up for AECross Senior Band.
Thank you.
This is, oh, there we are. We're on. We're live. Hello again. this is a piece that we actually prepared and sang at our Remembrance Day ceremony down at Field of Crosses. This is Light in the Hallway, arranged by Roger Emerson, made famous by the Pentatonix, and it features a few soloists to my right here. We have Zach Visser, Drayden Miller, Kiara Baldonado, and Kyla Isihara Gooding.
Close your eyes, lay your head down. Now it's time to sleep. May you find great adventure as you lie and dream.
If you're scared of the darkness, I will calm your fear. There's a light in the hallway, so you know I'm here.
So count your blessings every day. It makes the monsters go away, and everything will be okay. You are not alone. You are right at home. Good night.
My name is Layla.
And my name is Manu. We are grade 10s in the PVA Wind Ensemble and Central Memorial Concert Band. We are excited to introduce the Calgary Girls Charter School under the direction of Sarah McLean.
I can't believe that this time last year we were performing with CGCS. Central has many girls' school alumni in its band, and we're excited to hear them play again. Please enjoy their performance of Arabian Nights by Alan Menken and arranged by Johnny Vincent,
The Bonsai Tree by Julie Giroux,
and Celtic Aran Dance, arranged by Michael Sweeney. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
This is the final song for the Central Memorial Concert Choir. I just wanted to tell you about our last piece and also celebrate Greg Massey, who's our collaborative pianist and has helped us through all of this. Thank you to Greg Massey. Teamwork makes the dream work, absolutely. So this is Apple Tree. It was released last year in Istanbul at a World Choral Festival, and it is written by Katarina Gimmon. She is based out of Vancouver, and she arranged this, I should say. It was originally by Aurora, who's a Norwegian singer-songwriter, and it is an encouragement for us all to reflect on how we see ourselves in the world and our impact on the earth. We have some percussion, so get excited. we have Tina on the güiro, we have Miko on the cajon, Greg is on our form of this bass drum, and then we have Judith and Kiara clapping their hands very enthusiastically. And we also have like desk, there are a lot of layers. Very exciting.
Bye. Okay. Hello, my name is Miss Greenbow. I am the orchestra teacher at Central Memorial High School. I'm here to introduce our last piece of the first half of our concert. And I'm not as charismatic as the other music teachers, so I made a script. So here we go. The next piece came about for a few reasons. The first is that last year, around this time, Mr. Mailman, Ms. Hillestead, and myself traveled to Chicago for a music conference. While there, we went to see the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. You may have images of a Philharmonic Orchestra from somewhere in the Siberian North in your mind right now, but you would be wrong, because the TSO is a very American-style, holiday season-themed, stadium rock spectacle of electronic instruments, lasers, pyrotechnics, and musicians on suspended platforms. It was the kind of show where it's really hard to tell who is there ironically and who is there unironically, and by the end, we weren't really sure which category we fell into either, because we definitely all came home with concert t-shirts. So then in the spring of last year, in an impressive display of student activism instigated by one of our violinists, Joseph, our PVA students all signed a petition to play the Nutcracker Suite. I can confidently say that nobody here got what they wanted. The CBE offsite people downtown said we couldn't actually suspend musicians from the rafters of the Jubilee Auditorium, so the teachers were pretty disappointed. And our students are now fairly certain that the ghost of Tchaikovsky is coming to seek his revenge for this interpretation of the work. But we are very excited to have, for the first time with us at a concert, dancers from our wonderful PVA dance department. Please enjoy A Mad Russian's Christmas as performed by the Trans-Siberian Orchestra, featuring a collaboration between PVA Strings with Miko on electric violin, PVA Band, and PVA Dance students who are under the direction of Suzanne Demers.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. It became apparent to me earlier that I completely forgot to introduce myself. I was just so excited to talk to you. Hi, everyone. My name is Adam Mailman, and I'm the director of bands here at Central Memorial High School. Earlier, you saw the PVA band. This is our concert band. As you saw through all of our performances at the beginning, we have several ensembles here at Central Memorial. You saw the auditioned PVA band, you saw the auditioned PVA strings, you saw the concert choir, which is open to everybody, and this before you right now is the concert band, which is also open to everybody. If you play an instrument, we want you to join this band. We've picked a set of music for you tonight that tells a little bit of a story, and so I wanted to share with you what it was. The first piece is by Haley Woodrow, called Into Places, and it tells the story of being torn between two different things, between classical and jazz, between being a composer and being a performer, between living at home and moving out. I know a lot of us feel like we're often torn between at least two places, and so I thought this was a good place to start. From there, we move to a piece called The Cave You Fear by Michael Markowski, and that piece comes from a quote saying, that which you desire most, you will find in the cave you fear. And so as we face our fears, we will find, hopefully, that which we desire most. And once we have reached it, we will be finishing with a beautiful piece called Pure Imagination, which hopefully you will all recognize. Folks, this is the Central Memorial Concert Band, and I hope you enjoy our show.
Thank you.
Hello. I also realized I forgot to introduce myself when Adam said that. I was like, oh yeah, I think I also did the same thing. My name is Amanda Hillstead, and I run the PVA vocal program, as well as concert choir and vocal jazz at Central, and I work with musical theater students, all of the things singing. I love my job. That's the only thing that I can say about it. It's the best job in the world. I get to work with these wonderful humans, and it is one of my favorite things. So, thank you. Yes, I appreciate that. We are going to perform My Favorite Things, featuring the dancers who are under the direction of Suzanne Demers, and also featuring Leo Donahue.
Good evening. My name is Krista Wilson, and I'm a member of the Central Memorial Parents Association. Before we announce the winner of our 50-50 draw, we'd like to just say a few thank yous. We'd like to say a big thank you to our feeder schools for joining us this evening, as well as all of our parent volunteers that have helped out with our recent performance and fundraisers. We'd like to thank our students for all your hard work and dedication, and to our teachers for making our students the best that they can be. And now, to announce the winner, the chair of our CMMPA, Nimrod Dell.
Thanks, Krista. So we had our CMMPA raffle draw for the winter raffle that has been going since September, correct? And the final number for the total ticket sales was $2,945. And the winner will take home half of that, which is $1,472.50. So, you ready? The winner is William Jones. Is William in the audience? That's your dad? Yay! I swear it wasn't rigged. Thank you, William Jones. We will be emailing you with the details for how we can get that cash prize to you. Congratulations, and thank you everyone for coming to our wonderful evening of music and dance.
The students that you see here represent all of the string players at Central Memorial High School. To have an orchestra program in a high school is quite an unusual thing. There are only two in the CBE, and so this is a really unique program that we offer here at Central. We have our PVA students who auditioned to be here. We have our standard students who were either graduates from our beginner program or came with a few years of playing experience already. And then we have a very special group of students who are our beginner players. So these players started on their instruments in September, and they're here on the stage now with us tonight. So grade nines, if you're in the audience and you think you might want to try one of these instruments, that's where you can do that. Beginners, could you give your bows a little wave? Like wave your bows up in the air? Yeah, give a big round of applause for our beginners. The first piece we will be performing tonight with our beginners is Into the Sky by Brian Balmages. After that, the orchestra will perform North of the Mountain by Doug Spada, that features, again, our harpist Aria, Sweet New Moon by Japanese-American composer Nikiko Nishimura, and our last selection will be an arrangement of the finale from Tchaikovsky's Serenade for Strings. Tchaikovsky, if you can hear me, we hope this will make up for what we did to the Nutcracker.
Thank you.
Okay, we have one last piece for you tonight, but before we do that, we have a few thank yous to give out. Now, sometimes we do this thing called a band clap. Has anyone heard of a band clap before? No? Yes, maybe? So I'm going to teach it to you all. Here's what we do. As I'm saying the people that we thank, we're going to rub our hands together. And then when I'm done, each person that we're thanking, you're going to give one big clap for that person all together. You ready to try? So we have quite a few thank yous for tonight that made this amazing concert happen. The first thank you I would like to give now is where you start rubbing your hands together. The Central Memorial Music Parents Association for enabling us to enrich our program in so many ways, including those helping out tonight. Parent supervisors for coming to events and on trips with us. The tech crew and staff at the Jubilee who've been amazing for their expertise and professionalism. Our amazing clinicians for all the work they do with our students and their sincere, heartfelt involvement in our program. They're amazing. The music team, my wonderful colleagues, Mr. Mailman and Ms. Hillestead, as well as Greg Massey and Jody B. The ongoing support of our learning leader, Michelle Crimmins, and school administration, Ann Crom, Brian Cheney, Krishani Stars, and Jerry Ma, for all they do every day to make our program happen. CBE Board of Trustee member Nancy Close, who is here with us tonight, thank you. Our feeder schools for being here to celebrate music with us tonight and making such beautiful music. Awesome. And finally, our families for all you do at home to support what we do here at school. Yeah. Awesome. Thank you so much, you guys. So just a few quick notes before we end tonight. Our program is looking forward to having the grade nines we heard come and join our program next year. We hope you are all there. As a reminder, applications are open right now for our PVA program. The auditions are in January to join that. And everyone, all of you, are welcome to join our standard program as well as our beginner programs in orchestra, in band, in choir. They are all fantastic places to be part of music in high school, and we can't wait to see you. Okay? Thanks for grade nines. Where are you? I can't see you guys, but. So our last piece for the evening is, for the third year in a row, a collaboration between concert band, orchestra, and concert choir. And it's as well the namesake for our concert. We do these collaborations, and they are super unique. We don't actually know anyone else who does them, to the point where we've gone to like very large conferences and asked composers, like, do you have anything written for like band and strings and choir? And they just shake their heads. They're like, no, nobody does that. Well, we do that. So every year we search high and low for some really cool pieces to perform together. This particular piece we started putting together at our Camp Kindle retreat in October. And then since then, all 120 whatever of us have squished into the music room to continue rehearsing this together. I need to say I feel so honored to work with a team at Central that takes projects like this on and works so collaboratively with each other to make things like this happen. It's really special. I love my job. So I think everybody backstage is probably ready. I'd like to invite Adam Mailman to the podium to conduct Christopher Tin's music from the game Civilization VI, Sogno di Volare, The Dream of Flight. Thanks, everybody. Have a great night.